it's been known for many years that the winter months, the low temperature and low humidity is associated with flu mortality in humans. However, it wasn't really known what causes this mortality in the winter months. What we found, first of all, is that the low humidity impairs the ability of the respiratory tract, or the lung and the nose, to get rid of the virus. In the airway cells, there are these cilia, which are hair-like projections that are constantly moving particles along to get rid of these inhaled particles. However, in low humidity, what we found is that the cilia movement, as well as the particle removal, was impaired. And this is particularly important for people who are very susceptible, such as the very young infant or the older people above age 65. The mortality from flu mostly occurs in this age group. To increase humidity, there are a few things that one might do, purchasing a humidifier and humidifying your house or workplace or hospital is a direct way of increasing humidity. Take long hot showers and inhale very, very moist air, and that seems to also have some impact. Another reason we found that humidity impacts the host disease in response to flu is that there is an impairment of innate immune defense mechanisms that's conferred by type 1 interferons, which are cytokines that are antiviral. These type 1 interferons are important to induce hundreds of genes that counter these viruses. However, we found that the low humidity impairs the expression of these interferon and interferon-stimulated genes. So how that happens at low humidity is completely unknown. That's another area for us to study in the future. How does inhalation of low humidity air impact immune defense against the virus? That's a key and a new area of study.